A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. How many sentences? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Gayatri, I will answer that towards the end of the session. Please remind me again. So 8 sentences, boss. Big one. Okay. So what do we do for jumble sentences? We identify the topic sentence. If that's not working, then we look at connecting links, right? Links we'll have to figure out. So I want you to, Sai is like, OMG. Surya also, OMG. So I'm gonna give you some hints, okay? Whatever I can quickly spot. Still is a descriptive clue word. It can't be a topic sentence. The political process has been fouled by the politics of... So which means there has to be a sentence preceding explaining why it has been fouled, right? There has to be a preceding sentence. Today, blah, blah, blah. After all, again, is a descriptive clue word, which means there has to be a preceding sentence saying something, and then you, in addition, you add this, right? After all, so and so. The South Africa of Mandela's dreams is likewise, which means again, there has to be a preceding sentence. Yes, yes. If this question comes in the exam, yes. The tendency is to skip it, because by just looking at these 8 sentences, we'll lose it. But since Pragyam has put it down, let's go ahead and see if we can figure this out. Okay. It's a problem solving session. So let's solve the problem. Slums still exist in the cities. What cities are they referring to? Corruption is endemic and our institution efficient and gloriously obvious. This is more like a giving us more information, right? Why suddenly they're talking about unemployment among blacks is high. Okay. So because we have Mandela, right? We're referring to Africans here, right? That's another word to denote them. Now, let's look at, what is the question? Ma'am, how to choose E as fourth sentence? Please explain, I'm unable to find out. Okay, I don't understand this particular query, but I'm just going to try and jumble this. I mean, unjumble this. Gayatri, I will explain to you towards the end of the session. This is a problem solving session. I will answer that question towards the end of the session. You will remind me later to not keep posting that question again and again. Okay. Huh. Now, let's look at this. See, Anuba, it can't be B because it's saying still amid the problems faced by the two countries. What two countries? There has to be a sentence that is talking about these two countries, right? What is that sentence? Okay, what is that sentence? Oh, Rishika, too much Rishika. I'm going to take Rishika's thing. C, F, G, A, E, H, B, D. Okay, now, yes, it is correct, Sai. I'll come to that. I'll answer that question for you. So I've taken Rishika's sequence. Okay, let's see if this is the right sequence or not. See, today the India that Gandhi helped shape. Right. Why is this definite article here? Because it is specifying what Mahatma Gandhi has helped shape. The India that he shaped, right? So that way, in the definite article here is absolutely fine. Today, the India that Gandhi helped shape appears to be in disarray. Now, one of the things that I always keep saying is, see, corruption is endemic and our institutional, who is this R referring to? That's my problem, Neeraj. Chandra Neeraj. I have to have a sentence referring to, because we have Mandela here and we have Gandhi here. So which institution is it talking about, right? I don't know. It can't be my topic sentence, G. Right? So I'm going with C. Yes, so far correct, Rishika. Today the India that Gandhi helped shape appears to be disarray. One of the ways in which you can quickly form links is to ask questions, right? Ask questions. Why? Disarray means what? Disarray means disorder, confusion, right? So why is India in disarray or confusion or disorder? What can be the next? So you need to look for sentences that are answering that question. Why is India, what Mahatma Gandhi helped shape at that time, why is it today in disorder? Why? What is the sentences that talk about that? Disarray means dis, not array. Array, if you dissect the word quickly, Surya, dis is a negative prefix, which means not or none, right? Array, if you look up the meaning of array, it'll talk about some sort of an alignment or something like that. So something that is not in line, something that is not in the way at which it has to function, right? There's some sort of a disorder or confusion. That's the meaning. Anyway, so yes, F is also talking about that. But the only thing is, if you notice, they are referring to two particular countries, right? One is India, one is South Africa. So we need to pick sentences which are referring to India. We also need to pick sentences that will probably refer to South Africa as well, because it says the South Africa of Mandela's dreams is likewise all but shattered. So just like how India is in disarray, South Africa also is not in good shape. So I need to be careful with the sentences that I choose, which represent India and which represent South Africa, right? I definitely know H has to relate to E. Why? Because it's making reference very specifically with blacks being our clue word. So it is referring to South Africans. So EH can be a link, right? Okay, you've got this link right here, Rishika. What else can be a link like that? Let's look at that. Caste and community, very, very predominant to India, right? Politics of caste and community. A, G, corruption is endemic and our institutional efficiencies are gloriously obvious. Endemic means what? What's the meaning of endemic, anybody? Usually we use endemic when we are referring to disease, right? Something that is very prevalent in a particular locality or region or population. So, corruption has been of course, we can say corruption is not just exclusive to a particular country, but corruption is endemic, meaning it's very, very prevalent. It's like a disease almost in our population, in our institutional efficiencies, and gloriously obvious. So I'm going to connect the political process has been fouled by the politics of caste and community. Institutional efficiencies that are glorious, obvious. So I'm going to look at GA as a link describing India. Okay, I may be wrong. So you've got this link also correct, Rishika. Okay, let's look at other links. Still, I'm at the problem. So did we get all the links right? Let's just see. So I have C. Oh, we have F here. Slums still exist in the cities and crime is rife. Okay, now usually when you relate to South African countries, violence and crime is on the higher end, right? So I will relate F to put it under South Africa. So where is South Africa? E, H. I'll probably club F also here, keeping in mind crime is rife. Okay, again, I'm just going by guesswork here. EHF. Okay, I'm clubbing these three. So now let's just put all of this together. Okay, I have C is my topic sentence. So your only thing that is out is F, Rishika, for you. Let's look at BD if this is a link. So still amid the problems faced by the two countries, okay, the image of Gandhi and Mandela is that of benevolent leaders whose actions could not be comprehended by us ordinary mortals. Okay, why? Answer question. And the question that answers is D. After all, history cannot be anticipated by those who make it. Yeah, that makes sense, right? We are busy creating history, so we can't understand what these leaders are trying to do. BD is also linked. Super. So now let's put all of it together. So I have C. Okay, since I have put F after EH, I'm going to go with GA. Then I have EHF. And then I have BD. So the only difference, Rishika, apply context clues, Rani and Gayatri. What do you think can be the meaning of rife? Basically, rife means something that is very common, something that is probably, what can I say? It's on a higher end, very extensive. That's the meaning of rife. So, my sequence is Pragyam here? See, you got your links correct. 1, 2, 3. So, specific questions, you'll still be able to get marks, Rishika. But Pragyam has to come in. Has to come in. Confirm if this is the sequence. I agree with UGV. But I'm just looking at, you know, two pointers for India and two pointers for, what can I say, South Africa. See, if you look at it, C says, today the India that Gandhi helped shape appears to be in disarray. So we have two pointers. One is G, corruption is endemic and our institutional efficiencies are gloriously obvious. A, the political process has been fouled by the politics of caste and community. Then I have the South Africa of Mandela's dreams is likewise all but shattered. Then I have another two things. So since we are talking about their problems, more than one problem, so that's about it. Gloriously obvious means it's very transparent. You know, all the corruption that happens in the country is so transparent, is gloriously obvious. Like we don't even feel bad about it, you know. Unashamedly, it is obvious to all the public. So there could be, so Rishika, you also might be right in terms of sequence, right? I'm just blindly going by, just looking at couple of clue words here. It's a pretty, very extensive one. I will not attempt this question if it comes in the exam because it's just too much. It'll take up a lot of your time. So the best thing to do is obviously skip this. But I think for us to, you know, in terms of just understanding. Sorry, what was size? Why not AG? Yeah, that could also be a possibility. Corruption is endemic and our institutional efficiencies are gloriously obvious. It's in disorder. Yeah, it could be. I know, Chandra Neeraj. It's very annoying, right? You just post the question in the forum and you don't turn up for the session. Okay, anyway, I'm just going to move forward.